The hospital doctor is a pediatrician looking after his care. They are going into detail to see if there was perhaps if he had some risk factors or you know, children might maybe he had just gotten better from another infection. So there are many things that contribute to your immune response. So it's not anything to say that one person will definitely be very, very ill and another won't. Meningitis on a whole is something that is a serious infection. So if you could imagine that the meninges are protecting our brain and spinal cord, and your brain is responsible for everything in your body, just having meningitis, whether it's viral, fungal, bacterial, that is a major diagnosis. So people with meningitis, no matter what organism causes it, may have long-lasting side effects from meningitis. Some people recover but are not able to hear, or it affects many different aspects. So we can't definitely pinpoint to say who would get severe meningitis or who won't. Now, having said that, with meningococcal meningitis, that's the Neisseria meningitidis that I spoke about, that we don't commonly see in Belize. With that meningitis, people, children in particular who are prone to it, and teenagers, they get very, very ill. And it has a very high mortality rate. I was just talking to the epidemiologist, and we have not had a case, I think, for at least 10 years, a documented case of meningitis. So it's not, definitely not a common infection that we see in Belize. In other countries, there are many cases of meningitis, but in Belize, it's not something that we see often. And I know that we have had suspicion for adults having meningitis, but for children, it's been a long time.